about 31, I had a question coming out of section 3.3, number 37. And here we were asked to use our graphing calculators to find the maxes and mins, and then figure out where the functions are increasing and decreasing. So this is my function in here for 37. So let me go to my y equals, and what was it? T square root t minus, or t plus 3. So I'm going to go over here, and let me clear out what I have. And I will do x times the square root of x plus 3. Keeping in mind that I can see I have a domain issue, because again, our three domain issues are fractions where the denominator is 0, radicals with an even index, and a negative radicand, which is what we have here, and then logarithms. So I don't have a fraction, I do have a radical with an even index, and I don't have a logarithm, but I had that radical. So I need to make sure that x plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0, because we're allowed to square root zeros or positive numbers. We just can't square root a negative number. All right, so let me go ahead and hit zoom 6, because I'm not sure what window I had. And I can see that you can see right at negative 3, that's where the domain is just beginning. And let me scroll down to the answers here, and I'll show you how I did that, right? I set the radicand to be greater than or equal to 0, so that would give me t is greater than or equal to negative 3, and that would make my domain from negative 3 to infinity. All right, so I can see there's a minimum here. Let's go find it. I'm going to hit second and trace, and since it's a minimum, I'm going to hit option 3. Now, you can either use Blinky, I call it Blinky, affectionately call it Blinky, or you can just type in some numbers. If I look, to me, it looks like that minimum is around negative 2. So I actually am just going to use Blinky here just so you can see it. I'm going to get to the left of that minimum. That looks good. I'll hit enter. And then let me move to the right of that minimum. That looks good. I'll hit enter. And then I just hit enter through guess. And here we go. Oh, so our minimum is at negative 2, comma 2. And I only care about the x coordinates when I'm looking at intervals of increasing and decreasing. So I can see I'm going to decrease from negative 3 to negative 2, at least in the x direction, right? And then I'm going to increase from this x value of negative 2 all the way up. So that's why you see me saying, hey, there's a local minimum at negative 2, negative 2. I'm decreasing from the beginning of my domain to that minimum value, and then I'm increasing from that minimum value all the way up to infinity, because I do have a right arrow over here. This function is going up forever and right forever. All right, thanks so much, everyone. I'll see you later. Bye.